today, there's one thing we all have in common. We all woke up this morning, right? So what was the first thing you did this morning when you woke up? Maybe you grabbed your phone and checked social media. Research shows that 44% of Dutch people and even 69% of our youth grabs their phone directly after waking up. And did you know that even one out of five people check their phone while making love? Well, I'm not going to tell you to throw away your phone, so don't worry. Can you imagine? I didn't take my phone, but grabbed a bottle of whiskey every morning until 6 years ago. Let me introduce you to Monkey. I got him when I was around 5 years old, when my parents went on holiday, so I wouldn't feel alone and I could feel safe. I had him with me all the time, at night in my bed, it's quite normal, but also during the daytime. He was even on the family portrait. Because I believed when I had him with me, I could conquer the whole world. I felt strong and safe. But when Monkey wasn't around, I felt insecure and panic and helpless. Years later, I realized I was always busy in my head, but felt really empty inside. And negative thoughts, they possessed me more and more, and even worse, I started to believe them. They became my truth, my identity for years. Nikki, you're not good enough. Nikki, you're worth nothing. Nikki, you're fat. No one likes you. However, Monkey, he comforted me, and he put those thoughts to the background. But sometimes I was so frustrated that I wish I could just take off my hat, empty it as a garbage can, and then put it back on. I was struggling with myself every day. And when you feel empty or you have other negative feelings, you want to fill the gap, right? So growing older, I started to need stronger monkeys like food, men, cigarettes to fill the emptiness. And finally, slowly, step by step, I created a gorilla, which was called alcohol. And it's okay if you have a few drinks sometimes, but in my case, in the end, I wasn't drinking the bottle. The bottle was drinking me. In the beginning, drinking was pleasure, just to relax with friends. In our society, it's all normal. We all know that, right? Drugs. Drugs, however, I was afraid of. Because you can get addicted to drugs, right? At that moment, I totally wasn't aware that alcohol is the number one addiction in the world and is been seen as a hard drug. And after a few years, I drank more and more, and I didn't drink just socially anymore. I grabbed every chance to drink. I even drank alone and in secret. And it's not like you wake up one morning as an addict. This takes years and years. It unconsciously sneaks into your life. It's the same when you ask someone, when did you become a grown-up? You just don't know the specific date. I went from alcohol use to alcohol abuse and eventually became heavily addicted in 2014. Even though I knew, rationally, that alcohol is toxic and it can ultimately kill you. So every time I said to myself, tomorrow I will stop drinking. There is no tomorrow. Let me take you back to a beautiful sunny morning in May 2015. Sun was shining, the birds were singing, and I was lying in my bed, alone, depressed, painful hangover again. I felt so powerless and I was crying. I felt like I had lost all connection with my children, with my loved ones, and much worse, with myself. And I realized this, Nikki, if you go on like this and don't take action soon, there will be no tomorrow for you. Life isn't always easy, right? We all have to deal with negative feelings, with pain in our hearts. However, it's the way we deal with them that makes a difference. I feel like shit and I want a solution now. I need a drink to feel better now. I have to check my social media now. Having pleasure, it's human and it's great. But when the reason for using or doing something is to numb your feelings, to make you instantly feel better, for me, it has nothing to do with true and healthy pleasure. I call it false pleasure, because when the short-term effect is over, the painful feeling knocks brutally on your door again, and this time, maybe even harder. Compare it to a credit card. It doesn't hurt until you get a bill, not even mentioning the interest that you pay for it. It can even get you downwards to addiction. I became addicted. And do you want to know how my cute monkey ended up as a big gorilla? Because there are actually different stages until you are addicted. Like I said in the beginning, drinking was pleasure. There were no negative consequences, and I had no craving. So it's just true pleasure. And when it's occasionally, I don't see the problem in that. Then it's just a joyful monkey. However, slowly but surely, I was entering stage two, the gray area, heavily used. Every time I said to myself, tonight I'm going to drink just one, and ended up drinking at least two bottles. So what about your phone? When you still look at your phone, when you don't want to, maybe you're even looking at your phone right now. Nowadays, the whole world is 24/7 at our feet. We are always on. Our brain is constantly exposed to all kinds of new temptations. After a few years, my cute monkey became quite strong and I entered phase three. I became an alcohol abuser. Regret whispered in my ear after another dark and painful night. And the words, I will never drink again, lost its value more and more. Finally, I became addicted. The last stage. The Dutch word for addiction, verslaafd, means literally being a slave. I had no control over my use anymore. For me, it was bottle management. It was getting more and more a full-time job, my own destructive comfort zone. And from outside, I tried to keep my head on. But from inside, I was dying. Buying two bottles of wine, because just one. What if one gets empty? Putting vodka in a water bottle to survive another day at work? I can't even imagine I was that lying, manipulative person. Some people, you know, they may seem successful at first glance. But you know what? They may carry a big secret of addiction. We are often not aware of it because they are stars in hiding this from the outside world. because they are ashamed. I was ashamed. Maybe your neighbor has a drinking problem. We often think addicts are men without teeth lying under the bridge, right? But you find more addicts in the boardrooms, in companies, than under that bridge. When we don't talk about it, it's not there, right? Well, worldwide, 6% of all deaths, 6%, are caused by alcohol consumption. Think of liver diseases, cancer, but what about coma drinking, traffic accidents, violence? Let me take you back to that beautiful sunny Tuesday morning in May 2015, which wasn't so beautiful for me, remember? Story is getting better now. I took all my courage, called a clinic and asked for help to break out of the prison of alcohol and to get my life back. In my opinion, finding help is a courageous step if you want positive change in your life. By accepting help, I became aware of my behavior, which had an enormous impact on me. It's all about behavior. When you are aware of your behavior, then you can decide to take steps to positive change. Dr. Wayne Dyer, he's a great inspiration for me. He quotes the magical words: if you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Let me tell you a story. It's about an old Cherokee, old gray wise Cherokee. He's teaching his grandson about life. "There's a terrible fight going on inside my heart," he says to the boy. "And it's between two wolves. One is evil, he is self-pity, anger, fear, ego. And the other one is good. He's love, peace, happiness, compassion, faith. The same fight is going on inside you and inside every other person too." So the grandson, he thought about it for a minute and then asked his grandfather, "Which wolf will win?" And the old wise Cherokee simply replied, "The one you feed most." Maybe you feed with a modern addiction. It's not just alcohol. What about modern addictions? Like online gaming, online gambling, your social media, your phone. They bring us joy, for sure. But please be aware that they can also become a strong monkey or even a gorilla, what happened to me. So, when you are dealing with a monkey, you could ask yourself the question, is this truly what I want for my heart? Or even the question, is this beneficial or helpful to me? And when the answer is yes, please enjoy. But when the answer is no, you might be dealing with false pleasure. And you can change that if you really want to. And now you might think, well, Nikki, easily said, but how can I do that? It's not easy. I know. I will share you some of my experiences. First of all, I transformed bottle management into self-management. I made it clear to myself, I am responsible for my life and no one else. Instead of asking myself the question, why me? I take a moment to reflect on the situation and take the power within myself. I have learned how to fly, F-L-Y, first love yourself. Compassion is key. Only a few years ago, I found the courage to open up and share my story of addiction in public. It was scary, for sure. But you know what? When you are vulnerable, most people want to share their story too. And it gives so much fulfillment to have deep and true connection with people. And today, I'm taking the ultimate step and sharing my story in a TEDx talk. I feel relieved and grateful now, being aware of my monkeys and being able to deal with them, because it's still a jungle out there. But I am not dependent anymore. And what truly motivates me is the outcome of it, what it brings me. Happiness, peace of mind, freedom, success, both private as in business. And most important, I can be there for my loved ones if they might need me. Dealing with my monkey made me discover my own power, my own natural power to change. And we all have that natural power, but we forget sometimes. Maybe you recognize this. What a day. I need a drink. I need to check my social media. You know, take for example social media. We humans, we need human connection, not an internet connection. So what is your monkey? Deal with your monkey when it's little to prevent it from becoming strong and harmful, remember? Think about it. What could it bring you? Freedom, peace of mind. And you know what? You have to take action on your own, but you don't ever have to do it alone. So, there is no tomorrow. Take the first step today. It all starts with the first step. So, what is your first step today? Thank you.